Miss D. Hicks.
Watching the behind the scenes stuff that goes on. Hello, 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 Facebook fam. Hello, my indie voice audience. And to think we haven't even started drinking yet. Hello, welcome, welcome, welcome. I am not in the studio. I am off site, but I've got my sister here, Trina. Say hello.
Hello.
And I've got our friend here, Sabrina. She has opened up her beautiful home here in Ocean City. Say hi, Sabrina.
Hello.
And we are just sitting here at on the deck by the water, chilling, getting ready to get our party on in a minute. But I wanted to connect with you guys. So, why is the interview playing in the background? Oh no, that's just a delay. So I want you guys to check out the Indie Vault episode, which is the very first episode that aired March of 2014. It was with Miss Gwendolyn Collins. She is DC's own singer, songwriter, producer, and vocal arranger. I mean, just an amazing talent. So make sure you guys check her out and check out the first interview. So, and we're going to say, well, we're going to say a July 4th toast.
Yes. If we got enough hands.
Yes. Do we have enough? There. We are going to toast to the 4th of July weekend.
Yes. Happy birthday, America.
Yes. 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 Woo, woo. So I want you guys to sit back, relax, and enjoy the very first episode of the Indie Voice Show. And I will see you next week, live and in color, back at the station. Thanks, guys.
Bye. Bye.
This is the start of your week. Left speaker.
Check.
Right speaker.
Check. Mic.
Check.
Banging beat.
Check. Here we go.
Miss Wendy Hicks.
Wendy Hicks.
Hello, hello, and welcome. Glad to see you guys. I have some friends, some help, family, you know. This is my first live broadcast, so I need these young ladies here to hold my hand and make sure I don't fall out. So I'd like to thank my viewing audience from all over the world, the U.S. and the world, actually. So let me tell you a little about the show. This is a spinoff of a Soul Fusion magazine, which is my magazine that seeks to help independent artists with projects, getting projects out. It is to provide information and resources to the artists, and it's also to kind of bridge people to information. For example, if you're trying to start a project, you need a songwriter, you need a producer, you need beats. So I just kind of want to bridge everyone together so that we can help get some indie music out. So one of the things, so this is one platform, and then the other platform is I want to host indie networking events, like a happy hour kind of thing. And again, that will be a way for artists to meet one another. And from that, we're going to form a directory that will, again, bridge folks. So if you are, for instance, looking for a musician, then you can go to the directory and find a musician, or if you need a songwriter. So that's why we're here. Okay, and so before we really get started, I've got to do some celebrity news, because that seems to be the main interest of lots of people. We all like to hear a little bit of gossip. I like to know that we're not the only ones in the world to have issues. So we're going to start with, this is, oh my goodness. So how many of you remember Casey Kasem? Uh-oh, don't start dating yourself. Do you remember?
Right.
Okay, well, what most people don't realize is Casey Kasem is actually the voice behind Scooby-Doo. Mm-hmm. I didn't know that.
Wow.
But back in the early 70s, Casey co-founded America's Top 40. And then in the late 80s, it was renamed to Casey's Top 40. Now, he, again, was a legend from way back in the day, and he, you know, actually boosted a lot of careers. I found an article in Billboard magazine that talked about how he is, you know, now 81 years old, and he's suffering with Parkinson's disease, and he's being isolated from his adult children. And apparently, his second wife, Jean Kasem, is allegedly not allowing him to see or communicate with his kids from his first marriage. So part of the dispute in the courts is that initially his daughter and her husband had power of attorney for his estate in 2007. Then in 2011, it was his wife became the power of attorney. So now there's a struggle with his estate. And it's really sad. And one of the things that struck me with this story is that you have a lot of families nowadays that are second families, and you have issues that arise from that. And in this case, again, his kids from his previous marriage, or his adult kids from his previous marriage, are not able to see him, and his health is failing. So it's very unfortunate. You know, my prayers go out to Casey and his family, and I hope that the situation gets resolved soon. So we all know about Robin Thicke and his wife, Paula Patton. Of course, we know they have separated. Wow, color me surprised on that. So after Miley Cyrus, the twerking disaster with Robin Thicke and his roaming hands with the young girls, she had enough and she said, you know what, I'm out. But now the latest news is that she's now considering taking him back, and she's more impressed with his relationship with his son and, you know, parenting than so much for the out his little public cries of trying to get her back. Mm-hmm. So that's pretty interesting. Now, speaking of staying together, we've got Scandal's actor Columbus Short and his wife, Tanee McCall. They called off their recently filed divorce in efforts to work things out. So sorry, ladies, he will not be on the market.
Oh,
I hope it works out for them as well. Little Kim is what? Pregnant. Oh, my goodness. Okay, so the 39-year-old claims that this pregnancy is not going to slow her down. She plans to be even more of a, quote, beast. And what in the world does that mean? More of a beast than she already is. Anyway, So she's keeping the identity of the dad a secret for now. So it'll be interesting to see some of the wild pregnancy outfits I'm sure she's destined to wear. We'll be on the lookout. And I also hope to see whether she's going to try to put out a pregnancy line or a baby clothes line. Can you imagine seeing a baby girl in booty shorts?
Mm-mm.
Oh, my. So, anyway, lastly, oh, my goodness, this is a shock and a tragedy. In the news now, some of you may have heard that Pastor Marvin Sapp is facing, it's possible that he is under investigation for an alleged stalker that followed him. She left her home in California, Talika Patrick. She claims to have moved from California to Michigan to be closer to him. She joined his church. She had contact with his children. She's now been missing since December, and Sapp is their primary suspect in her disappearance. So he's being investigated due to lies and inconsistencies in his statement. And there are claims that he had some type of affair with Patrick. Now, that's tragic. So authorities believe there's, quote, foul play involved, but they need to find the body to strengthen their case. You know, I had an opportunity to meet Marvin Sapp last year and found him to be very down-to-earth, humble, and nice. I pray he has no involvement in this disappearance and that she is okay. And I also pray that her family gains closure and peace no matter what the outcome. So we'll keep you posted on that. So that's it. That's all for now with celebrity news. Do you remember? Okay, so my friends have told me that I'm very well known for just bringing songs out of the blue that no one seems to remember or even think about. I love those songs that stir memories from the past, the good memories. So those real down-home feel-good type songs. This one song that we're about to play is dedicated to a special memory for me, and that is the birth of my daughter in 1988. It's by a young lady named Vesta Williams, and the name of the song is Sweet Love. Check it out. Thank you. love that. Woo! That took me back. That took me back. I know y'all remember that song. You might not want to admit it, but I know you remember. And so one of the things that's important with this show is that it supports indie artists. And so I want to let you know of what's happening around town so that you can go out and support some of the events. So I'm going to attempt to read these things because I can't rely on my memory for this, but I can't see. I can't find my glasses. So we've got March 11th, Lettucey is having her album release party at the Hard Rock Cafe in D.C. March the 15th, we have The Grown and Sexy featuring the Kings and Queens of Go-Go, and that's with Belladonna, EU featuring Sugar Bear, Familiar Faces, and more. They're going to be at the Hilton Alexandria Mark Center, so go on out and support them. March 19th, Micah Chevalier is having her live experience at Bethesda Blues and Jazz, and she will be the special guest next week. Yay. Big ups to Micah. Hey, Micah! March the 28th, Miss Gwendolyn Collins, who I will be introducing you to momentarily, is having her Elements of Rhythm show at Seven Oaks Event Center in Odenton. I will be there to support.
Yay.
March 29th, there's an Indie Soul Mixer, the Indie Soul Mixer 2014, and it's at the Silvana in New York City. So, you know, if you, you know, want to go and network with some indie artists, feel free to go there. March 29th, the Recording Academy presents Business Beats and Inspiration, and the subject is tourology. It's the tourology workshop, which will include topics on touring, such as venues and booking, sustaining multiple dates, engaging fans, and much more. The event is held at the Atlas on H Street Northeast. And as a side note, I would really like to recommend that artists join the Recording Academy to stay informed and connected with what's going on in the music industry. And their website is www.grammy365.com. April 19th, shameless plug, we have the Wendy Project, yours truly, Soul's Journey 3 with Mr. Kenny Barnes at the Navy Memorial Burke Theater. Now, so for more information of what's going on around town, you can go to Wendy_Soul Fusion, which is my Facebook page, and I'll have these events posted. And if you have events coming up, please tweet me at Wendy Soul Fusion. Also, again, I want to let you know that I'm planning an indie networking event in either May or June of this year, and I'm looking for interesting topics. So please tweet me suggestions at Wendy Soul Fusion. Okay, so we've got birthday shout-outs. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. So we've got my Facebook friends and family. Can I read this? Okay, we've got Greg Narr, Delec, Gary Coates, and my brother from another mother, LeCount Briscoe. Happy birthday, everyone. So that sums up this week's birthdays. So I will introduce, after the break, my very special guest, Miss Gwendolyn Collins. Excited about introducing my next guest. Yay! Woo-hoo! Y'all can clap. Hello, Mom just walked in. You know, even though we've known each other for such a short period of time, you know, she has become my sister in song and my friend. You know, she's one of the most talented, creative, humble, and sweet, down-to-earth artists that I know.
Thank you.
So let me tell you a little bit about, I call her Gwenny because I can, I'm her friend. So in August of 2013, she wrote, co-produced, and released her debut single, Share, with keyboardist producer Ollie Wright to unexpected international acclaim. DJs in the UK and throughout Europe picked up Gwenny's unique sound styling, and Cher went on to become a top 30 hit in the UK with the soul charts. She followed up Cher with her second single, Take a Walk with You, in September 2013, which debuted at number 8 on the top 20 independent breaking artist radio show. And on November 8th, 2013, she reached the number 1 spot, where it remained for 4 straight weeks.
Go, yeah, girl. Thank you.
We have fun. So, her latest release, Simple Things, is climbing the UK charts as well. Last check, it was number 14. So, let's take a quick break and listen to her latest single, Simple Things, and come back and meet Miss Gwendolyn Collins.
Thank you.
So happy.
Man, am I cheesing or what?
Go on and cheese, girl.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Go
okay.
on and cheese.
So hello, Gwenny, and welcome to the
Hi,
show.
Wendy. Thank you for having me.
You know, this is another first for us.
Yes.
You know, you supported me and was my first guest on Soul's Journey Series 1.
Super awesome.
You were my first guest for the interview at the Soul Fusion Magazine.
Super duper awesome.
Yes. My goodness. First, what else? What else do we have? And now first on the radio show.
Absolutely.
My first.
I appreciate it.
You know, the first is always special.
It's always good. I'm your virgin.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, we're going to get off of that subject right now. We're keeping this PG.
I appreciate it.
So how do you feel about being the first?
I love being the first of all things, but mostly, you know, I'm just so grateful that you actually appreciate me in that way to give me all these different opportunities to get myself out there and the listeners to hear my music. So I appreciate it.
Well, I thank you. Again, you've been very supportive and you've become, you know, a very good friend.
Yes.
And let me first give you a plug or shout out, a thank you, because you're the voice behind the intro.
Yes. That was fun.
And for those, none of you know yet, but I have a single that will be coming out in a few weeks, Welcome,
yeah.
which is the music that you hear on the intro. And Gwenny helped me with the vocal production and with, you know, putting the song together, recorded in her studio.
Yes.
So, again, I thank you.
And that was a lot of fun. And I thank you because, you know, you trusted me to actually, you know, co-produce this with you. So that was very cool.
Well, I mean, look at your track record. It speaks for itself.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, here, you know, as I said earlier, your first single was released August 2013. And here we are in March in like less than 7 months. And you've, you know, made some amazing strides already.
Yeah.
You're making your mark and you're steadily moving forward with the first single, Share, which is a great song,
Then
Take a Walk. And so tell the listeners and the viewing audience the story behind Share and Take a Walk.
Share, you know, you mentioned her earlier. I had the incredible experience of working with Miss Ollie Wright, who is a keyboardist and also a producer. She actually just said, Gwenny, you should try to write a song. I was always so afraid to write. Mm-hmm. You know, you really are vulnerable when you put your own stuff out there. So she was like, Gwenny, you know, write a song. So piece by piece, I started building a studio, trying to write. I will tell you, like, my first 5 songs I tried to write, I would never let anyone hear them. But this particular one, we were in the studio, and it's amazing how things just happen, because we were trying to record another song that we wanted to sell, and she just hit a chord on the keyboard, and I was like, Ollie, what is that? And then she put this bass line, and I immediately ran into the studio, and I just started singing, Once Upon a Time in Love's Land. Before you knew it, like, we wrote that song that night.
Wow.
It was amazing. And then Take a Walk, basically, I was having a party, and I wanted to have some product, and I wanted to have a CD, so I wrote Take a Walk. That was actually really fun and pretty easy to write, because the music is just so beautiful. Mm-hmm. So that was cool, and I, you know, used some music or some words from Aretha Franklin, Daydreamin'. So that's how that came about, and now I just write probably like 2-3 songs a week.
Man,
I love it.
I want to get back to the songwriting, but I just had a thought as you were talking about the song. So also share with the audience how, you know, you expected the first to do, you had a level of expectation for your first song, but then your second song took off faster than
it
the
did.
First song, and now the first song is kind of evolving.
It's kind of crazy, because my level of expectation for Share was that my friends and my family would hopefully purchase it, you know, through digital distribution. And then before I knew it, it was on the UK soul charts. But then Take a Walk, just like a month later, here Share was my baby. Take a Walk was more like something I did so that I could have product.
Mm-hmm.
You know, not so much like Share was like from my heart. And Take a Walk just went crazy. I just couldn't believe how it was just being so accepted you know, in London. You know, it was just amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Amazing. So you never know what can happen.
You really know. That's so true. One of the things, going back to the songwriting, I myself, you know, I kind of had, I wouldn't really say fear, but I had a level of anxiety about writing, because it's something that you kind of, if it doesn't come natural, you know, some people just wake up with a song. Then you're not really motivated to do it. And then sometimes it's all in timing. But one of the things that I want to bring out with Indie Voice is that, you know, I don't want you to get stumbled or feel like, you know, halted because you come into a pitfall. You know, if you have no experience writing a song, there are some things, whatever it is that motivates you to write, it could be, as you said, you hear a beat and it just kind of prompts something. So you just have to try. Just try it.
Absolutely.
And then it will come, because I was really shocked when I was, you know, writing Welcome. It just kind of came to me. So just a little tip, a little motivation to get you out there for those who don't want to write or afraid to write. Write! Write!
Absolutely. Right.
So what made you decide to go the indie route versus mainstream?
I just, you know, knowing me, people who know Gwenny know that, you know, I'm kind of hard to manage, and I have got to keep, you know, my creative freedom as far as what it is I want to write about, my image, you know, all of those things. So being independent is actually really working for me, and especially now with the internet and the digital distribution of songs, there's just so many ways to get your music out there without having to be tied to one of the big four labels. So for me, like, I feel like we are grassroots independent, selling CDs out of our trunks or at our parties or whatever, and it's cool, it's fun. I'm loving it. I really am. So
yes. So has there ever been a song that you just didn't feel 100% about and it just took off?
Take a Walk. Take a Walk. I didn't expect anything. You know, I was just like, okay, I'm just gonna put it out there because I want to put it on my product, and it did really well. And I didn't think Simple Things would. I mean, I love Simple Things. I mean, that really was from my heart, the dedication to my family and everything, and my parents who've been married for 50 plus years. But I guess you never really expect, and maybe that's the cool, humbling part of everything. When you put your stuff out there, you just do it from your heart. You do it for love, and whatever happens, happens from it.
So tell me, what was your first experience like performing your first release single live?
Oh, man. I believe I performed Take a Walk at your show. Was the first time I had did that one. And because we had an amazing band and we had amazing sound and we had amazing vocal assistance, it was super awesome. It was really fun. It was good, yeah.
Gosh, I know I was a little, I don't know, you get so used to hearing, you know, the recorded version of the music where it's perfect. You can go back and correct any mistakes. And then when you hear it live, it's a whole nother animal. But it's very fulfilling to hear your dream come to reality in both forms.
And when you have a great band. The thing for me, like, I always find, like, I forget my words to my own songs. But I can do the words for somebody else's, but I will forget my words in a minute.
Just forget words, period. I think, you know, as Kevin says, too many birthdays. And we're not going to go there, but, you know. Anyway, so have you ever written anything and then decided it was too harsh? I think I know the answer to this, but I'm gonna let you answer.
Yes. I will just say yes. I have a song that I renamed Wondering, but originally it was called F.U. Because I really just write so in the moment. Like, really, I write all the time. So whatever is kind of happening, or if I just see something happening with a friend, or I could see somebody arguing in the street, and then all of a sudden I'm going home and I'm writing about it. And sometimes it's a song, sometimes, because, you know, I think I'm like a rapper. You know, it's just me doing more spoken words. So I have one, but I've decided that I am going to release it with my CD. I'll just make it non-explicit.
So when is your CD scheduled to release?
It is scheduled to be released in June of this year.
All right. Yay.
And I am working hard. I took off from my day job every Thursday and Friday of March so that I could just concentrate on working on the project.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I'm sure it's going to be absolutely wonderful. I mean, because everything, you just have such a creative ear. And it's like you think you're a forward thinker. You know, it's like, and you can just place things where, well, for me, I wouldn't think to place it. So, I mean, that's very important and creative. So I applaud you on that. And I'm looking forward to it. I know it's going to be great.
I'm looking forward to it also.
So let's talk a little bit more about this whole indie artist movement.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you think, or what do you believe can be done to promote the indie artist movement a little more?
Oh, man. I think it's really like, what can we do for ourselves and what can we do as a group of people? My biggest thing is support. You talk about that all the time. That's why you're doing the things you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes your greatest voice is another independent singer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can shout all you want, oh, I have a song, I'm great, but when Wendy might put it on Facebook, Wendy has a song, or Annette or whatever, it can just reach a whole different crowd. So it's about support, it's about sharing, you know, like, I got a studio, come on girl, come to my studio, let's do this thing. So for me, I think the biggest thing is support. I'm not expecting any, you know, big label to really start, you know, helping us in that kind of way.
Mm-hmm.
So support.
Who knows? I mean, like I said, you keep going at this route, you could be picked up by a major label. I wouldn't be surprised. But, yes, it is important to support.
Yeah.
And one of the things... First, let me say that I have been performing in the DMV for, I'll just say, over 20 years. I'm not going to give exact numbers.
Right,
but
right.
It's over 20 years, and that's, you know, promoting concerts and doing cover songs.
Mm-hmm.
And so now I'm at the point in my life where, you know, I want to do original songs, mm-hmm. And so as I'm going through this process, I'm seeing where there are, or I'm identifying gaps. I'm seeing where, you know, people need help.
Yeah.
And so that's why I'm here. And again, as you said, support is so very important. And one of the things that I'm recognizing in this is that indie artists are a subculture. And for the mm-hmm. most part, there is a lot of support amongst us.
Yeah.
I think there can be more. Because, you know, there can be, just like with anything else, some cattiness. I haven't seen or experienced mm-hmm. it, but I'm sure it exists.
Right.
But I'm just, I'm thankful again to, you know, the artists that I have come in contact with and the people that I'm meeting on this journey.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know, it's exciting. I'm just looking forward to the next step.
Yeah, absolutely.
So we're going to take a quick sponsor break, and when we come back, you'll get a chance to experience the talented and charismatic Gwendolyn Collins.
Thank you. talk is sweet to me. We both know once I get to you, girl, I never wanna leave. I love your sexiness. You got me open, babe.
You got me, babe.
When we make sweet love, it's nothing short of magic, girl.
You just heard In the Groove from DMV independent artist Miss Micah Chevalier. And of course, as I mentioned earlier, she will be guest artist next week. You get an opportunity to meet her. And yes, also on that track was Mr. Brian Christopher, who is also a DMV indie artist. Maybe one day he will grace us with his presence. So let's say something about Micah real quick. She was part of Indie Soul Christmas project that we did.
Yeah, absolutely. I've been really blessed and lucky to work with some of the greatest talent in the DMV. And we had so much fun putting out the Christmas Indie Soul. Micah was with us, you, Miss Sydney Marie, Nia.
Yes.
We all recorded in the studio, had some chocolate wine.
You think that had anything to do with it?
I think that's why it was so good.
I think that's
why it was such a good Christmas medley. But it was fun. And when we talk about support, again, I mean, you're talking about women who get together and we supported each other. There was nothing negative about that experience. Not one thing. It was just so much fun. And the talent, our voices together, I just thought was incredible. So
yes. And see, that raised the bar because that's what I expect.
Exactly.
So
exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
That was great. So now you are going to do Take a Walk live for us.
Do a little Take a Walk.
Yes, I'm excited. I'm excited.
Yeah. I wanna take a walk with you. Ooh. Hey, baby, let's go away. I wanna take a walk with you. Hey, baby, let's go away.
I wanna take a walk with you.
Snap with me, y'all. Come on. Thank
yeah.
you. I've been anticipating having a moment. I see it so clearly. Us holding hands, walking in the park under stars. You're showing me your love. Consistently, love's overwhelming.
Yeah, you know this.
Instantly, your touch. Ooh, hey baby, let's go away. Maybe can we cherish in the time? I am yours and you are mine. Ooh, yeah. You are mine. Hey, baby, let's go away.